The normal plate, which is crowned on both sides by the bull of Taurus, and the image of the king, which is linked to the constellation of Orion, has been dated to 3100 BC by some Egyptologists, which is well within the age of Taurus. Others believe the Narmer plate was fashioned in 4468 BC in commemoration of the spring equinox and the beginning of the age of Taurus and the ending of the age of Gemini, the twins, hence the twin bulls. Clearly, a cosmological connection is made between the transition of one cosmic age, that of Gemini, to another cosmic age, that of Taurus. These ancient kings of Egypt were directly linked to the constellation of Orion, thus to a great king who lived and died before the last cataclysm which destroyed the cities of woman and man. In fact, the scribes of ancient Egypt tell us that the first kings of Egypt established their rule 15,400 years ago. As the Egyptian civilization prospered and grew, and with the coming of the new age of Leo 13,000 years ago, the ancient Egyptians erected a great Sphinx and possibly even the three great pyramids of Giza, all of which still stand today. The Sphinx, which has the body of a lion, the king of beasts, is believed to have also been crowned with the head of a lion, just as the statues of the bull and the ram have the heads of a bull and a ram. However, the original lion head became so badly eroded over eons of time that it was recarved several times and finally reshaped into the head of a pharaoh. Although the original nature of the head is debatable, that the Sphinx has the body of a lion and was erected to face the rising sun on the day of the spring equinox is undeniable. 13,000 years ago, and for the next 2,000 years, the sun rose in the constellation of Leo, the lion, the king of beasts, on the morning of the equinox. The Sphinx was designed to greet the rising sun in the house of Leo over 13,000 years ago. Moreover, the Sphinx suffered most of its erosion when inundated by torrential rains and a great flood over 13,000 years ago. Thus, the Sphinx provides additional physical evidence of an ancient, technologically advanced civilization that existed almost 13,000 years ago during the Age of Leo. As first discovered by Egyptologist R.A. Schwaller, the erosion of the Sphinx is quite different from the erosion observable on other structures in ancient Egypt. On the back and upper portions of the Sphinx and its nearby walls, the rock is badly worn, edges are rounded, and deep up and down vertical fissures are prominent, conditions usually created not by wind, but water and torrential rains. By contrast, the erosion seen on the Old Kingdom tombs is completely different in character and typical of wind and sand. These observations were later verified by Egyptologist John Anthony West and geologist Robert Schock, who concluded that the vertical fissures were indicative of severe water erosion and were caused by a long period of torrential rainfall or severe flooding which raised water levels to the very head of the Sphinx, with waves lapping at the shoulder and face. In fact, most of the erosion is not at the base or the walls of the Sphinx, but at the top of the back and neck. This makes sense as the body of the Sphinx was buried beneath the shifting sands for much of history and would have been protected from the ravages of rain and flood, whereas the head, back, and shoulders were continually exposed. Thus it appears that the Great Sphinx was erected almost 13,000 years ago during the Age of Leo and suffered a great deal of erosion when exposed to torrential rains and a great flood. It has also been claimed that the three Titanic pyramids of Giza were constructed over 12,000 years ago. Although there are claims and counterclaims regarding who built the three pyramids of Giza, even the ancient kings of Egypt refer to them as being quite ancient. In fact, although the grandest and oldest of them is attributed to Khufu, based on an obvious forgery and even a misspelling of his name, Khufu indicates that the Great Pyramid and the Sphinx had been constructed long before his own time. Khufu's funeral boat was not found in the pyramid, but buried outside. Clear evidence that the Great Pyramid was never intended to be Khufu's final resting place, but a pyramid belonging to another, more ancient king. The great king, Osiris, is associated with the constellation of Orion. Osiris may have been the last king of Egypt before the great catastrophe some 13,000 years ago. The pyramid complex is also oriented to the constellation of Orion. In fact, the layout and orientation of the three great pyramids of Egypt are a mirror image of the three main belt stars of Orion. However, they match not where the belt stars are located today, but the positions they occupied 13,000 years ago during the age of Leo. Indeed, not just the Earth, but our solar system, our galaxy, and the stars and constellations are in motion and change position over time. Most authorities agree that these first three Titanic pyramids were constructed first, well before the erection of all other Egyptian pyramids. However, what has puzzled the experts is the fact that the first three pyramids are not only many times larger, but have a degree of perfection not seen in all subsequent pyramids, over 100 of which are known to have been constructed during and following the reigns of the Third Dynasty some 4,500 years ago. Indeed, the pyramids created by specific pharaohs beginning during the Third Dynasty are stunted, lopsided, poorly constructed miniaturizations in comparison to the three great pyramids of Egypt. This is exactly opposite to what would be expected. Improvement in design and increases in size should appear in later copies, but this is not the case. All subsequent pyramids are stunted, tiny, and puny in size, and poorly constructed in comparison. Coupled with their incredible size and utter perfection, and other significant differences already noted, legend leads credence to the possibility that the three great pyramids of Giza were built by a different, technologically advanced civilization almost 13,000 years ago, and that later inferior pyramids were created 8,000 years later, some 4,000 years ago. Some ancient Arabian historians explain that these first three pyramids, which exceed all other pyramids in size and perfection, were created in anticipation of the great flood and calamity which the ancient Egyptians realized might destroy much of the world. Basing their conclusions on ancient manuscripts, ancient historians have reported that before the great flood, the king of Egypt decided to secure the treasures of all ancient wisdom. The king built the pyramids to preserve the records of all the profoundest sciences, the hidden wisdom of the ages, which were engraved in tablets and memorials which were stored within the great pyramids and made secure. According to one Arab historian who wrote in 1584, Sarid, one of the kings of Egypt prior to the great flood, was the builder of two of the great pyramids. Sarid had a dream where the earth turned upside down with all his people. The people fled in a blind rush and the stars fell down. All the king's advisors apparently had the same dream and predicted the end of civilization. So Sarid, the pre-diluvial king of Egypt, decided to build the pyramids in order to serve as a great museum and library where all the world's knowledge could be preserved. Indeed, the Great Pyramid itself was to be a source of knowledge and wisdom, harboring the answers to all questions regarding the cosmos and creation. In fact, the Great Pyramid contains a number of chambers, one on top of the other, similar to many university libraries. However, there is basically no evidence to suggest it was ever meant to serve as a tomb for an Egyptian king on his journey to the afterlife. As all who visit or have studied these grand monuments can attest, the three pyramids are not just the oldest, grandest, largest, and architecturally superior to all those that came after, but they are completely un-Egyptian. Unlike all other Egyptian edifices, the chambers and inner walls of the three great pyramids of Giza are completely barren of hieroglyphics and are lacking in any markings whatsoever. Typically, all Egyptian works from 6,000 years ago to the end of their civilization are covered with symbols, artistic renderings, and hieroglyphics. Not so the Great Pyramid. The interiors are completely barren. Moreover, the three pyramids are unique in that the interiors not only lack ornamentation, but there is no evidence of torchlight within the inner chambers. No smoke, no soot, no ash. Nothing to indicate how the interiors were lighted. Nothing except drawings of what appear to be giant electric lights and the discovery of an ancient electric battery. According to Plato and the ancient priests of Egypt, we know nothing of what happened in ancient times, because of these great destructions and pestilences from heaven that comes pouring down, and which leaves few survivors. And because after many generations, the survivors of that destruction die, leaving no written word. Now, these memories are myths. Be it memory or myth, ancient peoples from throughout the world all speak of a horrific cosmic cataclysm which destroyed the cities and civilizations of woman and man. And most blame the end of this golden age on a cosmic serpent.